What the fastest way you've seen someone ruin their life? I had a friend in college who had a tendency to act before thinking, but was generally fun and well-meaning. After I had graduated, my friend apparently got coerced by a woman he was trying to sleep with to try heroin just once. As I heard it, he refused initially, then caved because he felt pressured. My friend overdosed and died. Just like that, one bad decision ended his life. RIP Mike. A former acquaintance was playing around with a homemade crossbow that I'd helped him with. I was massively into archery and fletching, and he seemed serious about it. I typically made him leave it with me because deadly weapon. I have an explanation. He kinda didn't. Anyway, to convince his parents to let him join an archery club, he wanted to show off the crossbow we made. I thought it was a decent plan, so let him take it asterisk without any ammo asterisk. Turns out he was gaming me to get more playtime with his favorite toy. Had gotten hold of some bolts and was fucking around shooting his shed a fair bit. He somehow ended up firing a bolt that missed the shed completely, passed between the slats on his fence, and hit his neighbor's daughter in the spine. She hasn't walked since. He got fucked up real bad by her unstable older brother. They both did jail time. Acquaintance was disowned and ended up homeless. And now I'm not sure where they are in life. Edit, I've had a few people comment that even a stable person would want to fuck up someone for something like this. Truth told, I half agree. I still feel like it's important information to the situation. However, and just want to qualify the statement, asterisk asterisk, the beating he got was brutal, involved a crowbar, and left him with a broken femur asterisk asterisk. The difference between wanting to do something like that and actually acting on it is important. Also, we were 18 at the time, the girl was 12, her brother 21, for all those asking. Went to school with a kid who threw a rock off an overpass and killed a dude. Whole life down the drain at that point. Made international news. Edit, Flint, Michigan. Imagine being the dude that got hit. Just living your life, driving home from work one second, literally dead the next. This life is something else. My friend is a teacher. She teaches the kids whose dad was killed and said she just watched the poor kid deteriorate after the dad died. Super sad and really an effed up situation. About 50 years ago, when my great uncle was in his early 20s, he drove home so drunk that he ran over and killed two college students and didn't even realize it. After his initial incarceration, he didn't know how to function as a free citizen, so he keeps getting himself sent back to jail. For example, he got out of jail around a year ago and couldn't make his first month's rent. His solution was to walk to the convenience store, steal a beer, and sit on the curb waiting for the cops to arrive. I had a friend years back who was always kind of an odd guy, but he had a good heart. Anyway, one day, I was hanging out with him and a few other friends and he told us he was going to get a tattoo tomorrow and had this super cool idea, but he wouldn't tell us what it was because he wanted it to be a surprise. We saw him about a week later. He had tattooed 3/4 of his face green. Like, no design or anything, just solid dark forest green. Basically, he just left the top right quarter of his face normal and the rest was all green. He had been immediately fired from his job the day after getting the tattoo. I kind of lost touch with him shortly after that, since he moved to another city. I'd heard he wound up living in his car. No idea why he did what he did. He'd had a very good job in IT at a pretty big company and was making decent money. No clue why he thought permanently turning 3/4 of his face green would be super awesome. dropped out of a very good college with a full scholarship that his family could never have afforded otherwise. After 3 years due to World of Warcraft addiction. No, this wasn't me. I managed my addiction responsibly. Edit, we're thinking of different guys. The fact that dozens of replies are, hey, I know this guy, is disconcerting but not unexpected. Edit, I played WoW from release through Cataclysm but never really had a problem walking away from it to focus on life, which is probably the experience of most of the player base. After I quit, I started having intrusive thoughts about relapsing. Even 8 years later, but have never felt that I'd give in to that. When I lived in Vegas, I saw all these people come in and bet it all on black, then lose. Then the stare of disbelief as they realize their mortgage is gone and they have to explain that to whomever they had left at home. I remember a trip to Vegas when we got separated from our friend and she was trying to meet up by the casino credit office. Anyway, we didn't know where it was, so we asked an employee. He straight up refused to point us in the direction. Even when we explained we didn't want any credit, he would absolutely not tell us where it was. Guess he didn't want to see a bunch of dipshit kids ruin their lives at the casino credit office. I respect that man. Looking out for young people. I was there when my older brother tried heroin for the first time. Fast forward 15 years and he is constantly going to the hospital for abscesses that appear on his arms and legs and is almost completely cut off from the rest of the family because he's robbed our parents more than once. Every few years he swears he is going to kick the habit. The first few times we collectively ponied up cash to send him to rehab and tried to be as supportive as we could. After the 10th relapse or so, we were too exhausted to even pretend to be hopeful about his newest attempt to get clean. Edit, thanks for all of the positive feedback. Early 90s, my friend was a sweet theater nerd who went to the same college as me. She started hanging out with a sketchy crowd and ignoring her old friends. Especially when we tried to tell her she was losing herself. She ended up moving to Seattle to hang with her new friends. Growing up, she was the most sober person in our group. She never even drank alcohol, much less did any drugs. But 6 months later, she was dead of a heroin overdose. In the Air Force. This new guy joins and goes out to a bar, then decides to drive home. Gets a DUI. Loses all his rank, has to pay a ton in fines, but leadership fought for him and he was allowed to stay in the Air Force. 2 months later, as he's paying tons of lawyer and legal fees, he does something really stupid. Drives home from the same bar drunk and gets arrested. Loses his license and gets kicked out of the military. So loses all his income while he's thousands of dollars in debt. That's not even the worst part. A few months later, he celebrates being a civilian again by, you guessed it, going to the same bar, then driving home drunk. Arrested and put in jail for a while. I can't imagine he has many future career opportunities with a less than honorable discharge and an arrest record. Edit, I should have added that the third DUI included charges for driving without a license since he had it suspended after the second. I had an acquaintance who was pretty successful, early 30s, good job, homeowner, etc. His next door neighbors had custody of their niece, a 16-year-old cheerleader who was home alone all the time. They struck up a friendship. Need I say more? Actually, yes. The cops stop him randomly with her in the passenger seat. They ID her since she looks young. Call her guardians, who deny that he has permission to take her anywhere. Here's the thing, they had crossed a county line. Boom, kidnapping charge. They break him in interrogation and he admits to sex boom statutory rape charges. They convince him to unlock his phone and find her nudes in his inbox. Boom, child pornography charges. Boom goes the cell door. High school acquaintances were partying underage and some other kids with drama were buzzing the party in some stupid loud car. Drunk guy thinks the best way to handle this is to throw a huge paving stone at the car on one of its passes. Stone goes through window, hits passenger, mid-body, lap, not head. Driver panics and refuses to take passenger to hospital. Apparently everybody was under the influence. She bled out of internal injuries in the hours that followed. Guy who threw the stone is still in prison for manslaughter. ETA sorry woe, here are some answers to the best of my ability. No charges against the driver. Sorry, yes, still in jail, very reticent from all reports. Was trying to mess up car, not people, doesn't excuse it, just a detail about intent. Also I should have maybe rephrased how I know of these people. We were high school age when we met briefly. Not I knew them through my own high school. Deleted. Greater than waiting for a friend whose name he didn't know. He was just picking her up for dinner at Arby's with a crack pipe in his console. Took me too long to realize that was definitely not what he was doing. Abusing Xanax and alcohol fucked my life up pretty good pretty quickly. Crashed my car, got dumped by my girlfriend, failed all my college classes, and made a bunch of people hate me all in the span of like 2 months. Haven't touched Xanax in years and managed to somewhat pull my life back together. I just witnessed an 18-year-old kid that nearly killed his 5 14 to 17-year-old friends going 70 plus mph. Running from a cop after fleeing an illegal burn. The driver lost control and crashed the car. The kid had the audacity to say, I'm a minor, any charges won't stick. That cop hit him with one felony of reckless endangerment for each kid he hurt. A DUI, and several other charges, given that the two 14-year-olds both stopped breathing on the way to the hospital. Oh yeah. Those charges are going to stick. The driver seemed to lack any remorse in the way he spoke of the event, but also had no idea that we had to resuscitate two of his friends halfway to the hospital. Initially, he was heard stating that his charges would be dropped due to his age. But I hope that changed as he learned the condition of his friends. From boozy Friday night party to near life-ending mistake in a matter of minutes. All the kids are healing well. Edited to add clarification on illegal burn. We can't have bonfires because COVID destroyed firefighting resources and we simply cannot risk it. Also, I don't know how cops press charges but they are involved in it in some way. Sorry. I don't know how that system works. I just put the band-aids on you when you get hurt. Edited again to add, as this has gained some traction, I would like to add that it was not my intent to imply that I wished the most extreme or most LAX justice on this kid. I'm not the judge nor the jury, that's not my call. I simply put the band-aids on injured people. Part of my oath as an EMT is to provide unbiased care to all people that I serve regardless of the situation. However, I am still human and must cope with intense and awful emotions from time to time from the nature of my work. This call hurt me, and perhaps that can be seen in the words I initially chose. Venting those emotions and resulting frustrations on sources like Reddit genuinely helps me cope with the things I see and do, as it is an easy way to throw out anger to a vague source rather than harbor it and let it change me. However, It is always my highest priority to provide genuine compassion to all my patients in person, regardless of their role in the tragedy. I do believe there are worthy consequences for the driver's choices. But I also believe that ... of the patients in that car were somebody's babies. And I think it is important to act on the latter belief as often as possible. We need more love in this world, especially now, and if for no other reason, selfishly, to remind me how important it is to always strive to be kind even when I'm hurt. Thanks for reading Reddit. She took MLM seriously, invested into it, lost friends, everyone and money. Simple. My boss has a saying, you're only one more drink and one stupid comment away from losing your career. That being said, I watched a former co-worker pull a beanie toward the crown of his head and say, check it out, I look like Brian's cock. Single quote. Brian was his uncircumcised subordinate, sitting right across from him. My former co-worker was out of a job within a month, divorced within 6, and living on the streets within 3 years. Less than 24 hours. My ex-neighbor's ex-girlfriend went on a racist road rage rant that got filmed. It went viral on Twitter. I remember reading the news article and thinking about her for some reason. She wasn't named. It wasn't until months later that I found out it was her. She was fired from her $300,000 a year job next day and immediately started getting death threats. She had to move in with her boyfriend. She tried getting a job, but people would look her up and be like, WTF. She spent $10,000 on a reputation defender, changed her name, was shunned by many family and friends. Her boyfriend, who she wanted to marry, broke up with her because he couldn't stand the months of depression. She ended up leaving the state. I can excuse the racism, but depression is where I draw the line. Quote. I'm my own perfect example for this. Started abusing meth and hanging with all the wrong people. Within 3 months I wrecked my car. Lost my home. My relationship went up in flames and I caught some misdemeanors and felonies when I had only ever had speeding tickets before then. Now I'm on probation for the next several years or until I can pay off the thousands I owe the court. Stuck living with my parents at 34, single, jobless, and struggling massively with anxiety and depression. Yay bad choices. Yay consequences. I knew this guy in my 20s. He was kind of new to our little group. He brought this girl around. She was trying to fuck everybody. I didn't know him that well, but I tried to tell him about her. He didn't believe me and took her side. We stopped talking. When she was trying to fuck me one night, she told me he had a premature ejaculation problem and he was really lame in bed. She specified she really needed some good dick because he seriously only lasts like a minute. I wasn't interested in her and politely declined. Anyway, I didn't actually see it, but a few months later, I heard he got her pregnant. The fastest I know of someone ruining their life was about a minute. Edit, wow. Didn't expect this to blow up like it did. To answer some of your questions, that happened. It was about 10 years ago. He cut our whole group off so nobody knows any details. I suspect it's 50-50 whether it was his or not, but I'll probably never know. I was a licensed firearms owner in Canada, and I sold a handful of handguns to my crack dealer when I was still smoking a few years back. And it caught up to me 3 years after I got sober. I'm going to court for sentencing in a couple of months, with the prosecutor seeking 6 to 8 years. And although it may not seem like that much in the grand scheme of things, but since I quit smoking crack, I got my driver's license, started my own construction business, and I'm in a 4-year relationship with an amazing woman who is the reason for my getting sober. All of that is going to be gone. And my grandpa, who is the only family who raised me I have left, will most likely be gone because of him being 84. I'm not sure where you would count the life being ruined. The second I made the decision to sell the firearms. The second the RCMP and local police pulled me over with 20 cars in morning rush hour. My name being put in the newspaper with my crime. Or when I get sentenced in a few months. I've decided it was the second I made the decision. Deleted. New guy at a factory celebrated finding a job by doing a shot at the bar next door. During lunch. Got fired after 4 hours of work for it. It helps to be insane. I say that as someone who is certifiably bonkers. I worked with an engineer at a manufacturing facility at one point in my career. We'll call him Bob Dobbs. We had defense-related contracts with major players like Boeing. It was not this man's job to design anything, but to do manufacturing shit. At some point, within a year of my arriving, he began answering the phone with customers as Bob Dobbs, engineering manager, and insisting that all communication go through him. He got away with this for nearly 3 months until someone called the actual engineering manager, asking for Bob Dobbs. The engineering manager, due in no small part to the what the fuckery involved, a review of Bob Dobbs' work began. He had been redesigning, optimizing customer designs before they went to production. There was almost $1 million of scrap sitting on the shop floor. He was terminated and began a career delivering pizza. Greater than began a career tilde tilde delivering tilde tilde as asterisk asterisk Bob Dobbs pizza engineering manager asterisk asterisk. I was 14 and visiting family in Vietnam. A dude on a motorcycle blazed by on a highway and a few miles later, I saw several feet of his brains spilled on the road.